I have no limitations.
So, we've finally arrived at Renoise 3.5. By far the most substantial update since 3.0. Not just when it comes to the power of the new features, but also the sheer number of upgrades and improvements. So, hopefully there will be something for everyone. And we'll go over the most notable ones here, but as usual, the full changelog is available to read on the forums, link in the video description or below wherever this has been posted. As an alternative to the tracker interface, the phrase scripting engine lets you script what you want the phrase to be in the left panel, and it'll be automatically generated at the right. Inspired by Tidal Cycle's mini notation, the Lua scripting can be kept concise and elegant, even when constructing something complex. Creating rhythms, melodic patterns, chords, etc. is incredibly easy, while randomization can be inserted so the phrase plays differently each time. And if you like what you've made and want access to the regular tracker style of phrase editing, just rendered script. And you can keep generating new versions of a script phrase and rendering each one to its own individual pattern phrase. For those of you unsure if this feature is for you, we've included a wide range of presets with a focus on tutorials, which encourage you to make small changes and hear the results. Also note that scripts can have user inputs to regenerate the phrase in real time. MIDI mapping and inputs allows control via live performance. While mapping it to a macro, allows phrase changes to be automated during song playback. Next is something with a bit more mass appeal, and it's been a while since we had a new effect device. A splitter works just like a doofer when it comes to adding effects and setting up macros, but has the additional ability of splitting the audio into two sub-signals, each with their own effect chain. The subsignals can be one of three types: parallel for two identical copies, mid-side separates the mid and side channels of the sound, while frequency separates it into low and high frequency bands. Now, this is great already, but there's a few other really cool factors here. First, the frequency parameter can be automated, making it a powerful creative tool. We'll be right back. Next, meta devices can work across subchains, allowing the user to modulate or control parameters in the opposing effect chain. Third, just as doofers can contain other doofers, splitters can do the same. And this allows the audio signal to be split off into multiple nested layers, each affecting the audio in a different way and passing that onto the next split layer. Previously, you had to get creative with effect commands, modulation, or other features to create microtuning. Now, you can use two existing standards as part of a Renoise instrument's native scaling. For the widest choice of tuning formats, use the free MTS ESP Mini plugin on Windows and Mac, or Surge XT on Linux. If you're only using Scala tuning files though, then they can be loaded directly into an instrument without needing any additional software. And the other big advantage here is that Scala scales are saved with the instrument. So anyone you share the instrument or song with can just play it. The VST2 standard is being dropped from other digital audio workstations, so our plugin, Redux, has been updated to VST3. And with that comes a long-requested feature, MIDI out. So now notes and other instrument data can be sent to the host DAW through MIDI, with the most obvious use being Redux directly controlling other instruments. In the previous update, we introduced support for Ableton Link, and now you have the option to enable the start-stop feature, which is as simple as ticking the box in the preferences menu. If an instrument is using plugin or MIDI, the phrase editor's sample column can now direct notes to a specific MIDI channel, and this is huge for multi-timbral plugins, since this is an alternative to aliasing across multiple instruments. And while you're in phrases, the keyboard can be focused, so instead of playing single notes or editing, key presses will play the phrase. Our EQ effects received a nice update with the channel selection now always available, and there's two new options for applying the EQ to only the mid or side channels. And here's a more boring, though still useful device, the Notepad. Use them to remind yourself, or inform others, of what's going on in an effect chain. Especially handy for complex doofers and splitters. Oh hey look, the instrument automation device can just select parameters by clicking on the plugins interface. Wow, that was a lot of updates for scripting tools. Does that also affect the new scripting engine? Oh, it does. But what about the formula device? Ah, yes, there we go. And there's probably also tool API in it. Yes, with a special focus on the canvas, an HTML5 inspired GUI view for superior user interfaces. That looks really nice. No, don't do that. Definitely do this. That looks awesome. Okay, bye then. Now that you've just got RMS all over everything. Come on, this is just showing off now.
Sorry you didn't blow.
Okay.
You didn't learn your limitations. 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 I have no limitations.